Now, KSBW Weather Plus with Jim VanderZwan.
All right, we've got a beautiful day going here. It's closing out for fine high clouds, night sky, visible satellite, a little bit of fog out in the Central Valley, a few patches here. That all gave up the ghost real quickly, and we ended up with some nice numbers. Not bad for November, really. 61 in Santa Cruz and Watsonville. A little cooler up in the Santa Cruz Mountains, mid to upper 50s, but eased out of 60 there in Scotts Valley. Overnight lows, mostly 40s and a few 30s here and there, but well above the frost point, so no issues there. Upper 50s to low 60s. Ever heard the word isothermal? That kind of means equal in temperature. This is a prime example of where we're isothermal. Everybody all within about 4 or 5 degrees of each other by night and by day, which happens in the wintertime, unlike summer, when we see quite a bit of disparity in the temperatures. In fact, that's the case for the whole state. Look at the Central Valley matching up pretty good with the coast there. Warmer, Van Nuys, 68, 72 in Palm Springs, 53 at Lake Tahoe. There may be a little snow up there on Thursday morning. Be aware of it. It's if it holds together, but for the rest, just windy tomorrow. Seattle, 50, 58 in Denver, almost that in Dallas now. It's cooling off into Texas. Still warm out in New Orleans there. They still get that warm, humid air, and that's causing problems. Got a fairly significant storm marching across the map. Tornado warnings are up right now. Several twisters reported. No major damage yet. Most of this is going to cause some issue for people traveling on the East Coast tomorrow, stretching from Atlanta. It'll be past Atlanta by the time anybody from the West Coast gets there, so that's not a problem. Expect some delays in Washington on up into New York, Boston, probably snow in New England, too. The rest of the weather is on the West Coast, but most of that's up around Portland, Seattle, some delays, maybe SFO. Main upper level low is back here. Another low is moving into Canada. They've been getting hammered pretty good with wind and rain in Washington and Oregon. But this front right here, this is a big question mark. Seems like we've been doing that now for the last three storms. I'll give you an example. Here's what the longer range model does. It takes a system, pretty good rain in Northern California, holds it together for early Thursday morning, showers left over on Thanksgiving afternoon, and then it's gone. The rest stays to the north. Then a high pressure ridge comes in. All the models agree on that part. Some of the other models, though, do a different story. They bring the clouds in tomorrow, and then the rain comes in the Bay Area, and here comes the front, and look what happens early Thursday morning. It just falls apart. Not much to it. We might get a few showers. I'm going to have to play devil's advocate and keep the rain in for now. But if it doesn't rain, you'll know what happens. It stayed offshore and stretched apart. It could still happen. So it's one of those real iffy kind of deals. But we'll just go ahead and allow for it. In any event, it's going to happen when most people are sound asleep. And it won't be a lot of wind. It won't be a lot of rain. If you get a quarter of an inch out of it, consider yourself lucky. Temperatures remaining isothermal, if you will. Overnight lows, mostly 40s, a few 30s, highs 50s, and a few 60s, much like today. We'll knock it down a couple of points, but this is not a major cold front for us. High clouds on the map for tonight. We'll add more of those tomorrow. Call it mostly cloudy. There's a chance of rain during the night. Most of us going to have to wait till after the midnight hour to get even close to it if this thing holds together. And we'll keep a few showers in for Thanksgiving morning. By the time you get through with that turkey dinner, you want to go for a walk, you're dealing with a mix of sun and clouds. The showers will have tapered off if that system holds together. Beyond that, we're looking at pretty nice temperatures and maybe a couple of clouds here and there, but nothing wet. So, like I say, we're going to try and get it done early Thursday morning. If it happens, if it holds together, we'll know more maybe at 11 tonight or certainly by tomorrow. After that, we're looking at a lot of highs in the 60s over the weekend, even a few 70s, and easy travel weather. Just be a little cautious up in the Sierra tomorrow evening on into Thursday. After that, it settles down. So, there you go. Happy turkey.
Happy turkey. And then, happy of course, turkey. The shopping frenzy starts early this year on Thursday.
Well, that doesn't seem to, weather doesn't seem to factor into that mix at all. It's like golfers and fishermen.
No.
They're going to go anyway. You know?
No, they're committed shoppers. For sure. Yeah. And just to let everybody know, we've got all kinds of stuff on our website. And we've actually set it up this year that you can share.
Oh, cool.
So if you find that great bargain, this is a
this
golf
ought to be crazy.
We love to tell everybody about it.
Yeah.
You can tell us on the
website. But it won't be freezing that morning, which is also nice. And it won't be pouring down rain for those who camp out waiting for the door to open or whatever.
Like I said, they're committed.
Yeah.
They're committed.